It's Professor Dave. Let's talk about logarithmic bases.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
You've probably noticed the log button on your calculator. But you may then wonder what base is implied by this button, since every logarithm must have a base. If no base is written, then it is implied to be a base 10 log. This is called the common logarithm, and we use it for a lot of practical purposes. A typical logarithmic scale utilizes base 10 logs, in the sense that one unit in such a scale represents a tenfold increase. This is the case with the pH scale, where one unit down means 10 times more acidic, and one unit up means 10 times more basic. But of course, there are other bases that logs can utilize. Really, a base can be any positive number except one. It doesn't even have to be an integer. Actually, it doesn't even have to be rational. One irrational base that we will commonly use is the natural base, e. But what is e exactly? If we look at the expression 1 plus 1 over n all raised to the n power, this was originally derived to calculate interest. If a bank were to pay 100% interest annually, we would make n equal to 1, and the expression would equal 2, so you'd get back twice what you put in. What if instead you got 50% interest twice a year? N would equal 2, so you get half your investment as interest after 6 months, and then half of that total after another 6 months. 1.5 times 1.5 gives us 2.25. As n increases, if we were to calculate interest monthly, or weekly, or daily, this expression gets bigger, but at an ever-decreasing rate. Each increase in n produces a smaller and smaller increase in the value of the expression, or the additional money you'd have after a year. And as n becomes incredibly large, we get closer and closer to a particular number, but never quite get there. The limit of this expression as n approaches infinity is called e, and it is approximately equal to 2.718. If n were equal to infinity, which would mean that interest was being calculated continuously every single instant, we would get precisely e, and this is an irrational number, meaning that these decimals go on forever with no repeating pattern. Anytime you see e written with digits, it is therefore an approximation, no matter how many decimals we list, so we typically just use the letter e instead. Because e is the natural base, when we use logs of base e, they are called natural logarithms, or natural logs. When we use these, instead of writing log base e of x, we can abbreviate this by writing ln of x. If you see a button on your calculator that says ln, this is the button that takes the natural log of a number, which is the exponent that e must be raised to in order to get that number. E is an extremely fascinating number, and we will learn more about it when we get to calculus. But for now, we just need to know its approximate value and how to use natural logs, which won't really be any different from other logs. What if we are trying to solve equations involving logs with strange bases? How do we solve these on our calculators? We have a button for log base 10 and natural log, which is log base e, but we don't have buttons for any other base. We have to learn a trick called the change of base property. This says that if we have some log of x with base b, but we want to express this as a log with some other base, like base a, then log base b of x will be equal to log base a of x over log base a of b. Here is an example so we can get some context. Say we want to express log base 5 of 15 as having base 10 instead, so that we can evaluate this on the calculator. We would just do log base 10 of 15 over log base 10 of 5. This is roughly 1.176 over 0.699, or 1.682. To verify this is correct, let's look at the original log. This was asking what power 5 would have to be raised to in order to get 15. So let's raise 5 to the 1.682 power. And we do get 14.99. So given the rounding that we performed, this looks about right. We can also convert to natural logs this way. Log base 7 of x is equal to the natural log of x over the natural log of 7. This skill is good to practice, so let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.